take it rough.
Hey, while you find the stats, Rod, we're going to a couple more quick things on basketball before we get to the good stuff, which is football. You look that up. Let me put this on the screen. Let me get it in there. It's a full count. You know, of course, we blame it on the Boogie. We front the Boogie. So, of course, we want to give a big shout out to all our fellow individuals from the crib. Mikayla Rich from the City of Champions, of course, from the Flyers. This was last week, fellas. He got named to the Post-Dispatch. For those that don't know, that's the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. But he All-Metro Player of the Year. That means both sides of the river, Missouri, Illinois, both sides of the river. This is the baller y'all to be looking out for. 6'7" wing. He just signed with Kansas State. So I wanted to give him a big shout out, of course, for his new accomplishment. And then also from the 618, we got Jordan Pickett, 6'4" guard. He's going to be going to Edwardsville. Shout out to Edwardsville, to the Salukis, all our friends up there. Second team, Class 4 All-State, first team All-Southwest Conference from my old rival. For those that don't know, I graduated from Belleville West, two-time high school champion after I graduated. But definitely wanted to give those two gentlemen some shouts out, especially they're on their way to Division I colleges or whatever. Of course, there are more of these gentlemen from the All-Metro squad, but in particular, those two are from the 618, so I definitely wanted to give them a shout-out. But in particular, Rod, why I bring that up, because dudes brought something to my attention.
What's that?
As we talk about these young high school stars that get ready to go to the – make that next step to the next level in college, which we all love to see, especially D1 schools, we're falling back into this trap we thought we just got away from. What was this, episode 4 or 5 and the whole thing? Which was it? What was his name? Brandon Miller. Gun situation. So this is heartbreaking, guys. Want to bring this up here. So with all these stories that are going on, this was tragic to hear. This is Mikey Williams, from San Diego, absolute star. Y'all see the headline. Arrested on 5. I don't know who spelled felony. Why do you even put headlines up again? Don't let Dorian see that.
No, my brother, that wasn't me.
Fanoni.
Arrested on 5 felony charges. 5 felony charges. Let's get that off for the professor come back. But the point being, here we go again, guys. Another young star. Was he caught in the wrong place, wrong time, wrong situation? Hanging out with the wrong crowd? Again, it's like the Jordan, the guy from Alabama, it's like the Ja. Come on, man. When will these kids stay away from the guns? When will these kids realize he can't keep coming with your homies? And part of the problem with this kid, which I know kind of for a fact where he's from a gang environment. So it's very hard for him to get that gang environment that he grew up from and that he's around away from the fact that he's going to the next level. Dudes, take over. What was he supposed to be going to school?
He's supposed to be going to Memphis down there with Penny Hardaway.
Well, he ain't no more.
And it doesn't look like he'll be going there now. And, you know, like we talked about a little earlier, it's just a shame that, you know, these kids get caught up in the culture, you know, the violent culture, you know, and we talked about how, you know, music does play a part of it, you know, that image. For some reason, they feel like they have
on the right, dudes. Gentlemen, do you see the image on the right? You see what he's throwing up, right? You guys know what that is.
Yeah.
That is the problem. That's what's wrong with the culture. I don't understand it, dudes. Rodney.
It's just sad.
But you know what? So
these kids on high school, you guys have children. You got, you know, we know friends that have high school kids. These kids don't watch social media. They don't see the news. They don't see what's happening to the idols and the stars that they're looking up to, but they still put themselves in these situations.
Well, they want to be like their favorite rappers, and that's what their favorite rappers profess to do. You know, they profess to be hard, gun-toting, quick to shoot, on the, you know, quick to blast on the ops and all this other stuff. And it's just sad, you know.
Hey, Rodney, do you still have the details of his arrest? Because it's so similar to what happened with Brandon Miller. In the sense, because now I understand he's professing his innocence. Because now this kid's professing his innocence, and it reminds me of the Brandon Miller situation.
Well, I don't have to pull it up, but I can tell you. The allegation is that they were having a party, and there were some guests in the party that were not invited. So they were asking them to leave. The guests left, and allegedly they drove by and shot at the guest or whatever. It's five kids in the car, shot at the guest. And the description from all of the witnesses add up to this guy.
Can't miss that afro.
So here's my thing though. Mm-hmm. And I hear you dudes, and I agree. You know, mm-hmm. it's the
culture major, right now.
The culture that these kids live in, you know,
hip hop culture
will make them do stupid stuff. But at the end of the day, you did it, you know, allegedly. You did it, right? Did nobody put this gun in your hand and make you shoot at this crowd? Mm-hmm. You got a full ride scholarship, one of the top athletes in your class, going to the University of Memphis. More than likely, I don't know for a fact because, I don't know all the details, but more than likely, you have some kind of NIL endorsement deal.
Coming your way.
Coming your way. If you don't have it, you may get one. Mm-hmm. But there's opportunity for you when you make it to Memphis. So for you to make the conscious decision to grab a gun and blindly shoot at a house that where you know there's people in the house already, for you to blindly shoot at this house, it makes zero sense to me. None whatsoever. And to blame it on the culture, to me, it's just that's a cop out.
Mm-hmm.
Because the culture didn't put that gun in your hand. The culture didn't tell you to go out there and shoot your gun at these people.
And you have to have some kind of self-awareness to know that, okay, even if you're in a car full of other guys or whatever, they probably could name the other guys in the car, but I'm pretty sure everybody there could name Mikey Williams.
They know you.
He's the most popular guy there. And you just can't put yourself in those situations.
You know what's unfortunate also? They're calling this the Ja Morant effect. You see what I mean? So that's what we're talking about socially. They're actually calling this incident the Ja Morant effect.